great pleasure to be here with you today to talk about renewable energy in Punjab. At the outset, I must thank EQ Magazine for organizing this seminar in Chandigarh. Punjab has been in the forefront of the solar sector, and in the next few minutes, let me take you through a few slides of the story of Punjab. Mr. Modi, he has set up a target of 175 gigawatts of renewable energy projects by the year 2022, that means the next 5 years. And the category-wise breakup for grid-connected and off-grid captive power for solar, the target is 100 gigawatt, including 40 rooftop. Up till now, that means to the end of March 2017, India has already achieved 12.75 gigawatts. As far as wind energy is concerned, the target is 60 gigawatts and 32.28 have been already installed. Small hydro against 5 gigawatts, 4.40 gigawatts have been installed. Biopower, that means biomass, gasification, bagasse and cogeneration together, the target is 10 gigawatt, of which 9.35 gigawatt has been achieved. Overall, out of 175, almost 60 gigawatts have already been achieved. Now, what's Punjab's contribution in the RE sector? In solar, we have installed, as of the 31st of March, 843.27 megawatts of energy. Co-generation, that means biogas, biomass and bagasse, we have installed 410 megawatts. Mini hydro, we have 142 megawatts. Biomass in the IPP sector, we have 63 megawatts. And waste to energy, 1.5 megawatts have been installed. Punjab has a total of 1460 megawatts installed of renewable energy. Now, our land area is only 1.5% of the country's land area. Our total RE capacity which is installed is 2.5% of the national average. In solar, we've installed capacity of 843, like I mentioned. Under installation are another 200 megawatts. Rooftop solar, we have 76.5 megawatts. In Dera Bias, the solar capacity on a single rooftop, which is the largest in the world, is 11.5 megawatts. There's a solar capacity, rooftop capacity in a single campus, that's again in Dera Bias, that's 19.5 megawatts. We also have the second largest solar rooftop capacity in the country. This is a view of the rooftop solar PV power plant located at Dera Bias. As you can see, this is one rooftop and it's a sprawling campus. And this was commissioned in April 2014. It's the world's largest rooftop project. Now, we allow net metering in Punjab, and the regulations were notified by PSERC in May 2015, almost 2 years ago. The scope is from 1 kilowatt to 1 megawatt of power, and individual system you can have 80% of the contracted quantity can be utilized by the individual himself. The grid penetration percentage of distribution transformer capacity which is allowed is 30%. If you provide more than 80% of the contracted quantity in 1 year, then for the excess electricity you are not paid, but you can reconcile the accounts within 1 year, and all consumers are eligible for this. Now, the scope for projects with capacity higher than 1 megawatt is under consideration. Capacity installed under net metering is 12.5 megawatt, and the premises, 379 premises, are already operating with net metering solar rooftops. This is a view of the solar PV power plant on the canal. It's at Gangar branch, and I think this is a slightly older picture. What you can see are the pillars which have been put in the canal on which they have installed the solar panels. Now, as far as biomass generation is concerned, we have a village called Kokhan Khurd in district Mansa. A 10 megawatt capacity plant has been set up there, and this has been working since July 2013. We also have a few mini hydro projects. This one is located at Kanganwal. Punjab put up a waste cattle dung to energy project. It's a 1 megawatt plant set up in September 2004. It's a one-of-a-kind project in Asia. This is at Ludhiana and it's very successful. Now, what Punjab has a problem is with paddy straw burning. As you are aware, paddy is harvested at the end of September and by October, and by November the wheat has to be sown. So the farmers don't have enough time to clear the fields. They will conditionally burn the paddy straw which is left in the field. And we are seeing these pictures. Not only are they a hazard, they create pollution. The first sufferers are people in the farms, the children, the aged, the infirm, the ill. And not only in Punjab, this pollution carries as far as Delhi. And last year was a terrible year in which the pollution levels were the highest. And this smoke kept settling down on Delhi and it lasted for months. At the bottom we have a picture which NASA has taken from space, and as you can see, Punjab has got a lot of fires burning. So this is one area which we have to address as far as renewable power is concerned. What to do with the paddy straw? We get, I think, 150 lakh tons of paddy. Mini hydro project potential has been almost fully harnessed. We have no wind potential in the state. We have actually given a lucrative generic tariff for waste to energy projects, announced in line with the CERC regulations. But there is public resistance. Wherever you have a large waste to energy plant or a waste disposal plant, villagers or people in that area are up in arms. I think the government is trying to address this issue. Now, what are the barriers for renewable energy? First of all, there is a great imbalance, as you are aware. You need a continuous balance between generation and consumption. The power systems must react if the generation from one source fails. Solar and wind energy power plants are dependent on sunshine and wind, and such power cannot be firmly forecasted. There could be a sudden removal of such power from the grid. It can lead to voltage imbalance. It will create frequency variations. There will be a phase imbalance, and there's a generation of harmonics. Now, arrangement of power from other sources is required at short notice meet the demand. Biomass and cogen plants also are not available throughout the year due to their dependence on agri produce and fuel. Now, sugar mills, for instance, will be crushing sugar cane, and that will only be available in the crushing season. Then there is non-availability of this power during peak hours. Solar power is available only during the daytime. It's available during off-peak hours. You can't manage the morning peaks. Now in winters, all the geysers go on in the morning. In the evening, you know, there is street lighting, and at that time, this solar power is not available. There's another problem of creating a spinning reserve, which allows you to cope with the unpredictable balances between demand and supply. With a larger contribution of renewable power in the grid, it's difficult to plan such spinning reserve capacity due to the unpredictable availability of renewable power. The last problem is of energy storage. Solar and wind energy are variable by nature. Dedicated energy storage is needed to support integration of larger solar and wind capacities. Then there's a commercial problem of the economy of scale. Reliable higher per megawatt plant and machinery costs for renewable plants than for conventional plants. You need a larger land area per megawatt for solar, wind, and even for biomass. And and the tariffs are higher in each of these categories. Now, the international agencies have made surveys. They're trying to figure out which are the states which are creating conditions for doing business, for ease of business, and bridge to India has made a survey in which they found that it was easiest to do business in Madhya Pradesh and in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and in Rajasthan. Punjab was also one of the good states to work in. The states with some difficulty were Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and Maharashtra. The government of Punjab is committed to providing more and more renewable energy, and we are trying to work out arrangements in which we can create conditions for better ease of doing business, and rather than being somewhere in the middle, Punjab would like to be at the top as far as renewable power is concerned. So the way forward, by way of ease of doing business, Punjab is one of the best states, and efforts are being made further to simplify matters. The Regulatory Commission is fully geared. Thank you very much.